Your Rabb told the angels that I am creating a Khalifa on the earth. Oh Allah, are you going to create someone and place them on earth who are going to cause chaos and they are going to spill blood and they are going to do a lot of damage on the earth? Allah created Adam upon his image.
Adam was honored that he was created with the hands of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. A great honor.
Iblis is told to bow down. All of them did it except Iblis.
The first human being and the first prophet of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Adam alayhi salam.
Bismillah, alhamdulillah, wa salatu wa salamu ala rasulillah sallallahu alayhi wa ala alihi wa sahbihi wa man wala amma ba'd.
Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, your Rabb, told the angels that I am creating a Khalifa on the earth. What is the meaning of a Khalifa? It has two meanings. One who stands in the place of someone else, or one who assumes the position of another.
What did they say? They said, are you going to place on earth someone who will shed blood and cause corruption?
And they said, Ya Allah, we worship you. We glorify you, asking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, are we not doing a good enough job in our tasbih, in our glorifying you? Are we not worshiping you enough? Now Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala responds to them and says, I know that which you don't know. Allah could have given them the reasoning. Allah could have given them the wisdom. Allah certainly knows it. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala doesn't create without purpose. And it's very beautiful that the scholars say that when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, I know that which you don't know, what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala meant by that is that from this creation, you will have the Anbiya, the prophets. You will have Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. You will have the Shuhada, the martyrs. You will have As-Siddiqun, people of truth. You will have people of righteousness that the jinn could not produce at that level. There is no equivalent from the jinn of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and in fact from any creation.
How did the angels know that human beings will corrupt on the face of the earth? One explanation is that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala told the angels ahead of time that this is what the human beings will do. The second explanation is that the jinn were living in this world before and they caused corruption and they shed blood and they fought with each other and they corrupted this world and they caused so much evil. And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent on them armies from the angels and also Iblis to fight against them, and then they were pushed and cornered to the islands of the ocean. Iblis was from a jinn. Because he was so righteous, he was included with the angels and elevated to a very high level among the angels.
And now he's hearing Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala telling the angels that there is a creation that is superior to the jinn that is going to come, and that they are going to be given control of the earth. So there's a jealousy, an envy that's already brewing inside of Iblis before Adam alayhi salam is even created.
With each other, the angel said, let Allah create whoever he wants. He would not create someone who is more honorable than us and more knowledgeable than us.
Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created Adam alayhi salam on the day of Friday, that it is the last hour of the day of Friday.
Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam says, Allah created Adam from a handful of dirt picked from different parts of the earth. So there was black soil, there was white soil, there was yellow soil, different colors. And then some of the soil was taken from the mountains, some of the soil was taken from the valleys, and it was mixed together. So the children of Adam became red, white, black, and everything in between. And they became soft and tough and bad and good and everything in between. So you have some of them are righteous and some of them are evil. Some of them are easy to deal with and some of them are tough. They came out according to the material they were created from. And then this dirt was mixed with water. When it was mixed with water, it became mud. And then this mud was left for a while. And when you leave mud for a while and the moisture in it reduces, it becomes sticky clay. Then that sticky clay was left for a longer while. The smell of it changed and the color of it became darker. And that is black, smooth and smelly clay. That material was taken and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala molded out of it in the form of Adam, the body of Adam. That body was left to dry and it turned into clay-like pottery. When you knock on dry clay pottery, what happens? It makes a ringing sound.
At that point, it was just sitting there without soul. And Iblis started to go by that body and he started to enter into it and he started to leave on it and he started to knock on it and it would make like a vibrating sound as he knocked on it.
When he found out that it is hollow, he said, "This is a creation that is weak." And then he said, "If I am given influence over you, I will guide you astray. And if you are given influence over me, I will disobey you. He is our enemy from day one."
And Adam alayhi salam was 60 cubits, which is about 2 football fields. So Adam alayhi salam was huge.
Another characteristic of Adam was that he actually had a lot of hair on his head. Very hairy head. Most of the scholars also say that Adam was extremely handsome.
Allah created Adam upon his image. Now what is meant by this?
It is not talking about the image of Allah. It is talking about the image of Adam. Allah created Adam on the image of Adam. That would mean that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created Adam as he was in his adult form that remained with him. In other words, Adam didn't go through the stages that we go through of being an embryo, then a fetus, and then an infant, and then a child, then an adult. Adam was honored that he was created with the hands of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. A great honor.
Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, "Once I complete him, once I proportion him, and I breathe into him of my spirit, then you should fall in prostration to him."
Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala blew the soul into Adam. When the soul entered into Adam, the first thing that happened is he sneezed. Adam said, "Alhamdulillah, praise be to Allah." Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala told him, "Yarhamkallah, the mercy of Allah be upon you." That was the first thing that was told to Sayyidina Adam alayhi salam. He had the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala from the beginning.
And then as the soul continued to go into his body, Adam alayhi salam's eyes open and Adam alayhi salam sees Jannah. Now when Adam alayhi salam sees Jannah and he sees the palaces and he sees the trees and he sees the fruits and he sees all of this beauty around him, Adam alayhi salam actually tried to jump for those things before the soul reached his legs. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala made a comment. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, "We were created in haste." But that hastiness did not stop Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala from blessing us with His mercy. As Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave Adam alayhi salam his soul, all of the angels fell in sajda to him. They all fell in prostration. SubhanAllah, trillions and trillions and trillions of angels. Imagine the sight, all in prostration to Adam alayhi salam. This is what he wakes up to, SubhanAllah. And Iblis just stood there. As the angels made sajda, he felt a sense of pride. He felt a sense of denial, of envy inside of him.
Now Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala questions Iblis. "Oh Iblis, what prevented you that you did not prostrate when I commanded you?" And now look at the reply of Iblis. "I am better than him. Why should I prostrate? You created me from fire and you created him out of clay. I am better than him." You see the pride, you see the arrogance, jealousy. He was jealous. Why is he getting all of the attention? Where did he come from? Why is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala teaching him everything? Why is he going to be a khalifa on earth? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala immediately commands to Iblis, "Get out from here. For verily you are an outcast, you are banished. And verily, my curse is on you till the day of judgment." May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala protect us all. Now look at what shaitan says. He says, "My Lord, give me time till the day of Qiyamah." Look, after such arrogance, after such a display of arrogance, now he prays to Allah. This is a dua. Look at Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He answers the dua. He answers the dua. He says, "You are of those who have been given respite." Even after that, what does he say? He promises now, by your might, Ya Allah, I will surely mislead them all, except for your slaves who are sincere from them. He blames Allah now. Ya Allah, because you sent me astray, whenever they try to get onto the straight path, I will be there and I will mislead them. Then I will come to them in front of them, from behind them, from their right and from their left. You will not find them as thankful ones. May Allah Azza wa Jal make us all thankful ones. Ameen.
Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala told Adam, go to those angels who are sitting over there and tell them Assalamu alaikum. He went to the angels, he told them Assalamu alaikum. They said, may the peace of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala be upon you, and His mercy be upon you, and His blessings be upon you. This is your greeting, and this is the greetings of your descendants. Not hi, hello, good morning, or good night, or what's up. Assalamu alaikum, peace be upon you. In the beginning, Assalamu alaikum, and then after that, you could use any greetings you want.
Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala then extracted the children of Adam alayhi salam from his back. And Allah presented to Adam alayhi salam all of his children, from the first of them to the last of them. Can you imagine, subhanAllah, Adam is seeing how many billions and billions of years of human beings is Adam alayhi salam seeing in front of him? Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi salam says that when Adam alayhi salam sees this, all of these souls, Adam alayhi salam says, oh my Lord, what are all of these? What are these? And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says that these are your children, these are your offspring.
So Adam looked at one of them and he saw some bright shining light between his eyes and he liked him. So Adam said, who is this? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala told him, this is one of your descendants who is gonna come in the end of time. His name is Dawood. Adam said, what's his age? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, 60 years old. He said, O Allah, give him 40 years from my life. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala told Adam, then it would be written down and sealed. In other words, are you sure? Adam said, yes. So it was prescribed and sealed. That's it. And we were placed in the hands of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala asked us, am I your Lord? And we said, yes. Do you know that there is an agreement between us and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? And that is, we worship no one but Him. And we witnessed upon ourselves that we shall not worship anyone but Allah. And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, don't say on the day of judgment that I didn't know about that. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, and He taught Adam all of the names. That Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala taught him the names of everything. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given him the ability to identify objects and to designate names for these objects. And then Allah made a test and presented some objects on the angels. Tell me the names of these if you are true. They said, glory be to you. We have no knowledge but the knowledge that you have given us. You are the most knowledgeable and the all wise. And now it's Adam's turn to go through the test. O Adam, tell them these names. And when he told them the names, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala told the angels, didn't I tell you that I know the knowledge of the unseen in the heavens and the earth, and I know what you reveal and what you conceal.
Now Adam alayhi salatu wasalam was alone, and then one day he sleeps, and when he wakes up, he sees someone beside him. Just imagine his expression, the first female next to him. He was shocked, and then he asked that person, who are you? And that person said, I am a woman. And then he asks her, who created you? And then she says, Allah created me. Why were you created? Adam alayhi salatu wasalam asks her. And then she replies, so that you may find peace by me. And then the angels saw the expression on his face and they asked him, Ya Adam, can you name her? Or can you name this, what you're seeing in front of you? Who is this? Immediately Adam alayhi salatu wasalam said, Hawa. Why Hawa? Because she was created from something, min shay'in hay, from a living thing. She was created from the rib bone of Adam alayhi salatu wasalam.
And Hawa is the most beautiful woman that ever existed on the surface of this world.
Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala now commands them both to live in Jannah and eat, both of you, freely with pleasure and delight of the things that are there in Jannah. But then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala goes on to say, but then don't even think of getting close to this particular tree. Which tree? We don't know. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala knows best. Now shaitan begins his evil mission. Now shaitan, he whispered to Adam alayhi salatu wasalam, saying, O Adam, shall I not inform you of a tree? If you consume its fruits, you will be able to live for eternity. And you will also possess a kingdom that will never ever be destroyed. He tried another tactic. If you eat the fruit, you too will become angels. They kept on shunning the whispers of shaitan until finally he swore by Allah. He took an oath. By Allah, wallahi, verily, I am one of the sincere advisors to you both. So the minute he promised by Allah, he listened to shaitan and they both consumed the fruit. When they both ate of the tree, their private paths immediately became exposed. They ran away from one another. They started to pluck leaves from the trees and they started to cover their private paths. And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala addresses Adam alayhi salatu wasalam, Ya Adam, are you running away from me? And then Adam alayhi salatu wasalam replies, Ya Allah, I'm not running away from you. I'm running away because I am ashamed to face you. I have disobeyed you and that is why I am running. And then they both cry out.
Do you ever wonder, how could such a great Nabi commit such a mistake? Adam had the knowledge, but he didn't have any experience with the shaitan yet. We know what happened to Adam, and we know that caused by shaitan. And we have seen a long history of mankind, and we still committing the same mistakes again and again. We should question that. We should not question the fact that Adam committed this mistake. Allah taught Adam a dua to say, and then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forgave him. We have wronged ourselves. If you forgive us not and bestow not upon us your mercy, we shall certainly be of the losers.
Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala commands them to go down. Descend where? To this world. From Jannah, all of you. Where did Adam alayhi salatu wasalam descend? Where did Hawa alayhi salatu wasalam descend? This has been mentioned by certain scholars that Adam alayhi salatu wasalam descended fil Hind. In India, Hawa alayha salatu wasalam, somewhere close to Jeddah, in the lands of Arabia. You know, in Sri Lanka, you have a mountain known as Adam's Peak. Certain historians state that this may have been the point where Adam alayhi salatu wasalam descended. Before, Sri Lanka was actually joined to India until it broke off.
And Adam and Hawa were looking for each other until both they met each other in Arafat. And Adam and Hawa lived and started their lives and they started to live in the mountains. Allah Azza wa Jalla not only taught him the names of everything, but Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala also taught him how to deal with life. All the simple technical things that you need to survive. From Hawa, she fell pregnant 20 times. Each pregnancy with twins. A boy and a girl. So from Adam direct, he had 40 children. And Adam alayhi salam lived on earth for 960 years. In that 960 years, Adam alayhi salam saw many of his descendants. At least 6, 7, 8, and 9 of his grandchildren.
Adam was supposed to live 1,000 years. That's the time Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala told Adam you would live. So now Adam is living in dunya and years are passing by. Then when he was 960 years old, the angel of death came to Adam and tell him, are you ready to die? Because angel of death takes permission from the anbiya of Allah. Adam said, I still have 40 years to live. The angel of death said, Didn't you give 40 years of your life to your son Dawood? Adam denied. Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam says, Adam denied. So the children of Adam, they denied. Adam forgot and his children forget. Adam made mistakes and his children make mistakes. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forgave him. This was a mistake from Adam.
When Adam alayhi salam was on his deathbed, Adam had his children around him and he said, I desire fruits from the paradise. So his children didn't know much about the paradise. So they went out looking for the fruits of the paradise. While they went out on the way, strange men will appear to them. They were the angels. They were carrying shovels and carrying all the equipments of digging holes, and they were also carrying the shrouds of covering the dead, the white kafan. Angels asked them, where are you going? So they said, we are going to collect fruits from the paradise for our father. So the angels told them, go back, your father's life is coming to an end. So they went, and the angels came with him. When the angels entered the house, or the place where Adam alayhi salam was in, Hawa was sitting beside Adam. When she saw those strange men, she knew they were the angels. So she started to grab on Adam. She doesn't want to let go of him. So Adam said, leave me alone between myself and the angels of my Lord. The angel of death took the soul of Adam alayhi salam, and those angels went out. And in front of the descendants and the children of Adam alayhi salam, they were digging up a hole. They washed Adam. They covered Adam with the shroud, with the kafan. And then they prayed on Adam. And then they carried Adam to the grave and buried Adam and put the sand up at the top of the grave. And then they told the children of Adam, this is your way of burying your dead.
This is our father Adam alayhi salam. This is the end of the story. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to bring us together with our father in Jannah.
Wa sallallahu wa sallam wa baraka ala nabina Muhammad. Subhanallahi bihamdihi. Subhanakallahumma wa bihamdika. Nashhadu an la ilaha illa anta nastaghfiruka wa natubu ilayhi.